mollusks. Examples are the octopus, squid, clams, and oysters. The body is often divided into head, with eyes or tentacles, and muscle, foot, or vessel or mass housing the organs. Mollusks are triboastic prosomes, and many demonstrate bilateral symmetry. The principal body cavity is also filled with homochoe. All species of the phylum mollusks have a complete digestive tract that starts from the mouth and runs to the anus. They also sexually reproduce. Cnidarians. Some examples are jellyfish, sea wasps, or hydroids are big scary monsters. Most have sacs containing gastrovascular cavities, with a single opening that functions as both a mouth and an anus. I guess technically you could say a cnidaria can kiss its own anus. Has a radial symmetry, and movements are recorded by nerve net. Like peripherals, they can both asexually and sexually reproduce. They breach the sperm in the water, fertilize with eggs that release in the water, and then you're done, you have 50 million kids. Arthropods. Some examples are lobsters, crabs, and barnacles. They have a dorsal heart and have a ventral nervous system. All arthropods are covered by a hard exoskeleton made of chitin and polyacrylamide, which provides physical protection. They also sexually reproduce. Echinoderms are both bilaterally symmetrical and the adults are radial symmetrical. Echinoderms become sexually mature after approximately 2 or 3 years. Don't worry, it takes us a little longer, depending on the species and the environmental conditions. The eggs and sperm are released into the open water where fertilization takes place. Some examples are starfish and sea urchins, some of my favorites. Sponges can sexually or asexually reproduce. When asexually reproducing, they use internal or external budding. In sexual reproduction, sperm is dispersed by water currents and enters neighboring sponges. Peripherals have several cell types, such as pinocerocytes, porocytes, and cellulites. It's very interesting, if I do say, peripherals are one of the best sea animals I've ever encountered. Nematodes are bilaterally symmetrical and have a complete digestive system, but have no circulatory or respiratory systems, so they use diffusion to breathe, no biggie. They have no muscle, and they sexually reproduce, and usually the males are smaller than females. I would not be able to live like that, let me tell you. Root knot nematodes and roundworms are examples of nematodes. It is also believed, according to the show Doug on Nickelodeon, that nematodes indeed make the noise cuckoo-cachoo! Anyways, can sexually and asexually reproduce. Sexual reproduction allows the species to better adapt to its environment. Some Annelida species are hermaphroditic, while others have distinct sexes. Asexual reproduction by fission is a method used by Annelids and helps them reproduce quickly. The posterior part of the body breaks off and forms a new identical worm. Some examples are earthworm or leeches. Annelids are bilaterally symmetrical and tribalistic protosomes with a comb. Close circulatory system and true segmentation is something the annelid takes for. Poihomentheses have soft body and are ribbon shaped. They have flattened dorsal, ventrally, or, in other words, they go from top to bottom, and are bilaterally symmetrical. Flatworms are the simplest tribalistic animals with organs. They're hermaphrodites, which means they can spew out eggs and sperm. Examples are flukes and monogenia, also turbellaria.
You can't kill the metal. tried to kill the metal. But they failed, as they were smacked to the ground. New Wave tried to kill the metal. But they failed, as they were stricken down to the ground. Grunge tried to kill the metal. They failed, as they were thrown to the ground.